in handcuffs and things. That, of course, so when the case comes up in court, it's always dismissed. Always dismissed. You know. And, you know, if it ever happens here, it happens here. Go ahead. You know. Arrest me. You know, put me in your holding tank. You know, the whole precinct is going to hear preaching and singing. They'll be glad to get rid of me. You know. And then I'll just be right back out there again. So bad. Why get offended about it? Why get upset about it? I mean, why not be like the apostles there when they were taken and beaten for it? And said, thank you, Lord, for allowing us to suffer shame on your behalf. Okay? You're not going to bring the kingdom in. Okay? The kingdom will come when God the Father has said, okay, I've had enough. I'm cutting it off. Get your bride and bring her home, and I'm going to release hell on earth for 7 years, and then you can go back and take what's yours. That's when the kingdom comes. So, you know, as good intended perhaps as some of these politicians are, okay, as far as this is concerned, they're completely in the wrong. Plain and simple. And all they're doing is giving ammunition to the enemies of Christ to push and support that. You know, I'm not against, you know, a politician being a Christian, of course not. But if you think that you're going to mandate, legislate, enforce Christianity on the world, good luck. Ain't going to happen. That's just the reality of it. Okay? You'll do more for this nation on your knees in prayer and by being a witness, handing out gospel tracts and doing things like that, and by living a life in public that honors Christ, than you will with trying to get one single law passed. And that's the simple truth of it. Father, thank you, Lord, for your word. Thank you that we have your word. Lord, it tells us everything we need to know. And it's sad, Father, that misguided, devil-deluded Christians take your scriptures and wrest them to try to prove something that just is not so. Let us beware. And Lord, let us likewise be busy about what we're supposed to be doing. Father, again, I pray and ask, Lord, that you keep us safe, Lord, as we travel now on the roads to go to our homes. Watch over us and protect us. Give us safe, quiet, and peaceful night. And we pray and ask for these things in Christ's name. Amen.